my victory.
See, the Word of God is supposed to be what I call our common denominator. The Word of God is supposed to be our final authority. The Word of God is supposed to be what needs to help us where our relationships are concerned. But the bottom line is, if our God is a relational God, if our God said it's not good for a man to be alone, you and I are to seek relationships. When God created you and me, He wanted to have a relationship with us. Can I have an amen? And therefore, you need to endeavor to continually, you know, build on that relationship until such time that you can see the fruits of what you are giving in there. Don't give up on that relationship. Say amen, somebody. God did not give up on us. Relationships are beautiful and God wants us to relate, but ukhona Satan all the time to mess up our relationships. So these relationships, God created them for us to enjoy and for us to enjoy each other.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. It's good to see all of you here this morning. It's been a long time. You know, this whole load shedding, schedule and everything else has been messing up our morning prayers, but I'm glad that I am here this morning, you know, just to spend some time with you. I see, you know, some of our favorite people here, some of the people that are always here. I'm glad to see some men as well who have joined us in this prayer. A couple of people I just want to say hello to, or shout out to. I see Sis Nomsa Monaring, Memapala, Mr. Mukubedi, Nkateko Ngobeni, my lovely wife, Sena Nimosena, Sis Ricardo, Nechitoni, and I see Mr. Msalili is here this morning. I see Mr. Masilu Clifford Mafokwani, our prayers are with you, Brother Masilu. You know, we have always been thinking about you, and we believe that God, you know, continually gives you the comfort that you need. So thank you, sir, for joining us this morning, and many other people that are, you know, on YouTube and other places. I see Nkateko Ngobeni. I see Miss Zandimbata. It's good to see you, ma'am. Also, I would like to say hello to Justaf Apostri. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning and all the greetings to you in the name of our Lord and Savior. This morning, even before we pray, I want to share something, you know, or some scriptures that the Lord has laid in my heart, which I believe, you know, are going to minister not only to you, but I believe is going to minister to me. You know, last night, as I was thinking about what am I going to share this morning, and the Lord gave me this word that I'm going to be sharing with you this morning. It's found in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 27. John chapter 14, verse 27. I want to talk to you quickly before we pray about seeking peace or pursuing after peace. Seeking peace and pursuing after peace. John 14, verse 27. The Lord says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let them be afraid." This is the Lord Jesus speaking. He says, "I'm leaving you with my peace." He says, one of the things that is important, or one of the things that will be important where your life is concerned as my disciples is peace. He's saying that I'm leaving you with my peace. He says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you." Now, you got to remember what Jesus says, "My peace I give to you." He was literally saying to them, "I am Jehovah Shalom. I am the peace that you need." And if at any given time you are presented with situations and, you know, life things that are coming against you or that are heavy on you, Jesus says, "I am the peace that you need." He says, "The peace that you need, I give to you. My peace, I give to you." He says, not as the world gives you. He says, one thing that you need to understand is my peace is not the same as what the world gives you. Because you see, the world can promise you one thing, but then, you know, it's not going to last. It's not going to last. True peace comes from Jesus. True peace is found in Jesus. He says, "My peace I leave to you, with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, but, you know, I give you my kind of peace." So he goes on to say, "Let your hearts not be troubled." And he says, "Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid because you will have my peace. Don't be afraid because I'm with you. I'm with you." There's nothing so comforting as knowing that the Lord is with you. There is nothing so reassuring as knowing that the Lord is with you. He says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you." He says, "Let your hearts not be troubled." And he says, "Don't be afraid because my peace is with you." Now, I want us to quickly go to another passage of scripture. It's found in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 10 to 11. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 10 to 11. It says, whoever desires to love life and see good days. And I think he's talking to all of us here, at least many of us. He says, let him keep his tongue from evil. So he tells us how we can see good days and how we can experience, you know, good life here on earth. He says, keep your tongue from evil, number one, and your lips from speaking deceit. That's what he says right there. And then he says, let him turn away from evil and do good. That's the next thing that he's giving us, you know, as a tip. Then he says, let him seek peace and pursue it. Let him seek peace and pursue it. He says, whoever desires to love life and to see good days, he tells us the number of things that we need to do, but then he closes it by saying, let him seek peace and pursue it. If you want to see good days here on earth, you got to be preoccupied by seeking peace and pursuing after peace. There's nothing so special, nothing so good as seeking and pursuing peace. You see, you can have a lot of things, but if you don't have peace, you know, you are as poor as a person who does not have money. So peace is important that we need to pursue it and we seek after it. When you're seeking after something, you know, you literally search for it. You literally go after it. You're pursuing it. You after it. The word pursue is you have to, you know, find this peace. You have to go after this peace. So the scripture says, whoever desires to love life and see good days, he will have to seek peace and pursue it. Psalm 34, verse 14. It says, turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. Seek peace and pursue it. Seek after this peace and pursue it. You see, don't be pursuing after being right. Or don't be seeking to be right. Don't be seeking, you know, to always be above everybody else and, you know, everyone else are below you. Don't be seeking, you know, to look right. Don't be seeking, you know, to be the person. Don't be seeking and pursuing after those things. And the Bible says that you got to seek and pursue after peace. There are times where you just need to be saying, you know what? I am going to be the bigger person here. I am going to seek after peace and I'm going to pursue after peace. That must be our resolve right there. You know, we need to be saying, you know what? I am not going to be, you know, being preoccupied about whether people think I'm right or wrong or all kinds of things, but I'm going to pursue and seek after peace. You see, if you don't have peace in your heart, it shows on your body, on your physical body. When you don't have peace in your life, you know, your stress levels go very high. If you don't have peace in your life, you know, nothing tastes good and nothing, you know, it's will come to together if you don't have the peace of God in you. So you got to be like the book of Psalms says in verse 14, you got to turn from evil, do good, seek peace, and pursue after peace. Pursue after peace. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. I want to give you Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. It says, strive for peace with everyone and for the holiness without which no one will see the Lord. The Bible says, strive for peace with everyone. Strive for peace with your spouse. Strive for peace with your, you know, your friends. Strive for peace in every situation. Strive for peace. As a child in the home, or as a, you know, as a daughter in the house of God, or as a son in the church, you got to be striving for peace. Don't be that person who, you know, is always causing divisions and that person who's always wanting things to go the wrong way. The Bible says pursue after peace. You know, even when they wrong you at the church, even when they wrong you, you know, in that relationship, seek and pursue after peace with everyone, the scripture says. But Pastor George, I'm not going to allow anyone to play, you know, on my head. Pastor George, I'm not going to allow everyone to take advantage of me. Pastor George, I'm not going to allow anyone, you know, to use me as their doormat. Hey, listen, I'm not saying that you need to be used as a doormat. All I'm saying is, instead of fighting all of these battles that are going to drain your energy and, you know, and drain you and give you stress and bring you to a place of depression, you got to seek peace with everyone. Pursue after peace with everyone, and then you will live long here on earth. You will thank me later, I can tell you now. You will thank me later. And I don't think that the Bible will mention all of this if it is not important for you. And I've given you a lot of scriptures. I've given you many scriptures to prove to you that peace is what you need to be pursuing and seeking after. I want to give you another passage of scripture. It's found in the book of Colossians. Let me see if I can find it quickly. Colossians. I know in Colossians chapter, I believe it's chapter 3, verse 15. Let me see if I can find it. Don't have it on my notes here, but it's in the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse 15. Let me see if I can find it quickly. Colossians. I want to read that chapter because I think it is so important for us to get a hold of, because it is so important. Now, let me just type it for you. Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3, verse 15. And so if you have it, you might as well be reading it right now, you know, because it's one of those passage of scriptures that are very important. It says, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Now, remember when I opened up this teaching and I said that Jesus said, my peace I leave with you. My peace I leave with you. I'll give you the peace that the world will not be able to give you. So here it says, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace. The Bible says you and I are called to peace. We are not called to be fighting, you know, all these other battles. As a matter of fact, the Bible says that the battle is not ours, but the battle is the Lord. So he says here, since as members of one body, you are called to peace and be thankful. What am I saying to you, child of God? You can avoid a lot of things. You can avoid a lot of challenges. You can avoid a lot of headaches. You can avoid a lot of stress. You can avoid a lot of, you know, things that are just meant to destroy and, you know, and steal your sanity. Just pursuing after peace and seeking after peace. Don't be pursuing after people. I'm going to pursue after this one. I'm going to prove to them, you know, that I was right, some people say. I'm going to prove to them, you know, that I'm better in this relationship. I'm going to prove to them, you know, that I was right. I want to prove to them, you know, that I'm, you know, that I'm smarter. I'm going to, hey, listen to me. Seek after peace. Pursue after peace. Instead of being, you know, channeling all your energies and trying, you know, to prove to some people how good and how better you are and how right you were, pursue after peace. Can I have an amen, you know, from all of you that are watching me this morning? Pursue after peace. And as you pursue after peace, your life will be far much better this morning. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but I believe that this word was for many of us that are here watching this morning. I believe that even as you start your day, even as you're going to go to work, some of you are going to be at home, some of you are on leave, some of you, you know, are doing whatever you're doing this morning, just remember and meditate upon this word. Seek and pursue after peace, because the Bible says, as members of one body, you were called to peace. Let the peace of God, let the peace of Christ rule and reign in you, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. So this morning, I want us to pray. We are going to pray that, you know, God may keep us in perfect peace. Now, I know that the Bible says he will keep you in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on him. So we got to be pursuing peace. So I want us to pray and say, Lord, help me to seek for peace in every situation. Lord, help me to pursue peace in my home, in my marriage. Lord, help me to pursue after peace at my church. Lord, help me to pursue after peace and seek after peace at work. Lord, help me to seek after peace and pursue after it, you know, where my friends are concerned, my family, you know, my siblings. Seek after peace. Seek after peace. And many of you, you would know I'm preaching on relationships right now. And one of the ingredients that will make you have great, you know, relationships is seeking peace in your relationship. Seek for peace. Pursue after peace. Because that's what you need. That's what will keep you sane here. So let's pray that God may give us that peace. That's number one. Number two, we are going, you know, to pray for the body of Christ. I know there are, you know, many people right now who might be struggling. Some are still struggling. And you'll be surprised that some are still struggling after COVID. The COVID after effects are still haunting some people, that their faith has not been restored. You know, their love for God has not been restored. As a matter of fact, some people have gone awry, or they've gone away, you know, since the COVID dispensation. So my prayer for them is, God help them, that their light may be, you know, lit again. You know, they may be rekindled in their spirit, in the name of Jesus. So that's what we're going to pray as number two. Number three, I want us to continue praying for our nation. Oh, Pastor George, there you go again. Yes, there I go again. We're going to pray for our nation. We're going to pray for this nation. We're going to pray also this morning, not only just for the nation of South Africa, but we're going to pray for the nations of the world. We're going to pray for what is happening right now in Ukraine and Russia, which has really just caused the world to go into, you know, a tailspin or whatever it is that people call it. But we're going to pray for the peace of the world. And that's what we're going to pray for. And ultimately, you know, you and I are to lead a peaceable life. By the way, the reason why I keep on asking us to pray for our nation, the Bible says if we pray for our rulers and pray for those that are in authority, you know, even where our nation is concerned, we will lead a peaceable life. Peace. Peace is what we need. Peace is what we need. Are you ready to pray this morning? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we give you the praise, and Father, we honor you this morning in the name of Jesus. You are worthy of all the praise, worthy of all the honor, O God. You are majestic. You are the King of kings, and you are the Lord of lords, O God. You do great and mighty things that we know is not. You are the God that is with us. You never leave us nor forsake us. O rapo kati sala shile bekendere bos. Riba mando robo koshila mando kosi. Lere beketi la mando robo kosi talabashiane. Manda rababa koshile berianda rababa sita la babariane. Mondo robo koshi talababarianda la bosa. Father, the word promises us that you will keep us in perfect peace when our minds are stayed on you. Father, this morning, Lord, we are praying that our minds may continually be stayed on you, so that we may have that perfect peace that you have promised in the book of Isaiah. Heavenly Father, I am praying this morning in Jesus' mighty name that, Lord, we may experience this kind of peace that you have been saying, God, and you keep on saying to us that we need to pursue it. We are praying in the name of Jesus that we may have this peace in our nation, first of all. Father, we are praying that we may have this peace in our homes. Father, we are praying that, Lord, we may have this peace in our hearts. Father, we are praying in the name of Jesus that we may pursue, my God, after this peace, even where our jobs and our work is concerned. Lord, we are praying in the name of Jesus for this peace, Lord, in our churches, in our relationships. Lord, we are praying that, my God, we may be in perfect peace, Lord, in the name of Jesus in every situation. And I'm grateful that, Lord, you have promised us this peace. You said in your word, oh God, that I will give you peace. You said that this is the peace that surpasses all understanding, that will guard our hearts and our minds. And Heavenly Father, I am praying this morning, just like Jesus said, peace is important for us. Lord, I pray that we may pursue after it and we may seek after this peace. Heavenly Father, we are praying for peace, my God, in our marriages. We are praying for peace, oh God, in the name of Jesus, even with our siblings, Lord. We are pursuing after this peace, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in every situation. We are pursuing after this peace, oh God, even with our children, even with our spouses, even, Lord, with our parents. We are pursuing this peace, Lord, in the name of Jesus, even with our bosses. We are pursuing after this peace, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. I pray that God, even as the body of Christ, that we may walk in the peace of God that surpasses all understanding, that will guard our hearts and our minds. And Heavenly Father, I pray in Jesus' name that we may seek to be peaceful, Lord. And the Bible says that we will have, you know, good days. We will have good days when we seek after this peace. And Heavenly Father, I pray that you help us, oh God, in Jesus' name, to walk in this peace. Not only just to pursue it, not only, Lord, just to seek it, but Heavenly Father, I pray in Jesus' name that we may walk in this peace in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm also praying, God, for the body of Christ, that our faith may be restored, oh God. I pray that our people, Lord, who have not even been restored, and Heavenly Father, they have not even shaken off the effects of COVID on them, spiritual effects of COVID, you know, even on them. Some people are still, God, reeling, God, in that moment of that backslidden moment, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray that they may come out of it, Lord, in Jesus' name. That, Lord, that they may seek after thee, Lord, that they may reconnect with you, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus that they may come back to a place, Lord, of serving you, God, and doing that which you have called them to do. Heavenly Father, I pray in Jesus' name that those that have been, my God, and detoured, and those that have been bruised by COVID spiritually, Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, the Lord, that you may cause them, my God, to revive again in the name of Jesus. Revive them again. Heavenly Father, I pray that they may see the importance, my God, of congregating with other saints. The Bible says that we may not forsake the gathering of the saints in the name of Jesus. I'm praying, oh God, in Jesus, my name, that, Lord, we may walk, my God, that we may walk, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in understanding that it is in you that we live, it is in you that we move, it is in you that we have our being. Heavenly Father, I'm praying this morning in the name of Jesus. I'm praying, God, for everyone that I know, everyone that I don't even know, those for whatever reason, oh God, they've just chosen not to serve you anymore, oh God. Heavenly Father, for whatever reason, it might be because during the time when COVID was rife, that, Lord, they might have lost their loved ones, they might have lost so many people, but Heavenly Father, I'm praying that you comfort them this morning. But Lord, I pray that they may not forsake the gathering of the saints. They may not forsake, my God, coming back and serving you, Lord, in Jesus' name, and spending time with you, and spending time, my God, in your presence, in the name of Jesus. And Heavenly Father, I'm also praying this morning for our nation. I continue to pray for our nation, oh God. I pray for this wonderful nation of South Africa, for it is so special, oh God. I'm praying in the name of Jesus that the peace of God that I've been talking about this morning, I pray that it may prevail in this nation, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I'm praying for the peace of God that will continue, Lord, to reign and rule, my God, in our hearts and also in this nation. I'm also praying, God, in the name of Jesus, for the peace of God, the peace that we need, Lord, peace in the world. I'm praying for peace in the Ukraine and peace, God, you know, even amongst the warring faction, I mean, the warring nations, Lord. I'm praying for peace. I'm praying for peace in people's homes. I'm praying for peace, oh God, in every situation, Lord. I'm praying, God, for the peace that we need in this continent of Africa, this beautiful continent of Africa. Peace in Zimbabwe. Peace, oh God, in Mozambique. Peace, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in Nigeria. Peace, oh God, in Tunisia. Peace, oh Lord, in Malawi. Peace in Tanzania. Peace in Kenya. Peace, oh God, in the name of Jesus. In the DRC, God, the Democratic Republic of the Congo. I'm praying for peace in the Central Republic of Congo. I'm also praying, God, for peace, Lord, in Sierra Leone. peace, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in Togo. Peace, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the Western Africa, the Eastern Africa, Northern Africa, and Southern Africa, Lord. I'm praying for peace, Lord, in our continent, in the name of Jesus, in the continents of the world. And Heavenly Father, I thank you this morning. I give you the praise and I give you the honor, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, bakarise telebo koshi talamande babatisa lababashi. Ribebeke se telebo korianda lababasi kelebo rian. Medere bokoshi lamandro bokosi telebo si. Mandala kasi telegerianda labash. Father, I am praying for someone who is watching me right now this morning, who is praying with me and they have a sickness in their body. Father, I pray in Jesus' name that you may heal them right now. The Bible says you have sent forth your word and healed us. The Bible says that, Lord, healing is our portion. The Bible says that Jesus took our sickness and our pain, and by his stripes we were healed. I speak healing over your body in the name of Jesus. I don't know who they are, Lord, but Father, I pray that you touch them in the name of Jesus. Some people right now in Jesus' name that are praying with me, Lord, they need healing in their hearts, Lord. Healing, my God, right in the inside. They don't even understand what's going on. But Father, I am praying that they may be healed in the name of Jesus right now. In the name of Jesus. Some people are right now recuperating at home. Maybe they've been in hospital. Maybe, Lord, they've just been recuperating. Father, I pray that they may be healed right now. Total healing in the name of Jesus. I speak it, I command it in Jesus' name. Healing is their portion. And right now, from this moment forward, Father, I declare them healed in Jesus' name. Total health, total healing, God. Nothing missing and nothing broken. Father, I pray they may testify. Father, I pray that in the name of Jesus, that this healing may be sudden right now. In Jesus' mighty name. Immediate healing. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. This is the day that you have made, Lord, that we may rejoice and be glad in it. This day, oh God, I'm praying that those that are seeking my God, after seeking my Lord for solutions in different situations in their life, Father, I pray that let this be the day, God, that they're going to rejoice and see their answer manifest, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I am praying this morning in the name of Jesus. Those that have been looking and seeking for a breakthrough in whatever area it is, Lord, I am praying that let this day be their day of miracles. Let this day be their day, God, of breakthrough. Let this day be their day, God, of deliverance. Let this day be their day, God, in the name of Jesus, where they're going to rejoice and be glad in it, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for each and every one of these, my God, that are praying with me this morning. I pray that the peace of God and the favor of God may be upon them in the name of Jesus. Favor at work, favor at home, favor, my God, with their business partners. Favor, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in every situation. Favor, favor, favor. Let favor be their portion. Supernatural favor in the name of Jesus. I declare and I decree, Lord, that it may be well with them this morning in Jesus' name. I decree and I declare that, Lord, everything may work to their good for those who love you, Lord. I decree and I declare that it may be well in their lives. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Father, I give you the praise. Father, I give you the glory and the honor. And it's in the name of Jesus that I pray. It's in the name of Jesus that I pray. Amen and amen. Hey, listen, everybody. I believe that even as the Lord nudged my heart this morning, you know, to pray for some people who were sick, I believe that it was prophetic. I believe that there's someone who has been watching me here or still watching right now who needed healing in their body. The Lord says, take it. It is yours. Healing is yours. Don't tiptoe around it. You know, don't go around about it. Just know that healing is yours in the name of Jesus. Don't be, you know, being timid about it. You know, am I supposed to be healed or am I not supposed to be healed? Hey, listen to me. The Bible says, by the stripes of Jesus, you were healed. Take it. You were healed. Take it. You were healed. Take it. If you were healed, you are healed right now. Take it in the name of Jesus. Healing belongs to you. And I believe that some of you, the Lord has been ministering to you in such a special way, even where, you know, this peace thing is concerned. You know, you've been wondering how you're going to come out of that situation. And how you're going to come out of that situation is by you pursuing and seeking after peace in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Hey, listen to me, everybody. Tonight, I say tonight at 6:30 in the evening at House of Faith Church, 130 Plantation Road, Blue Hills, Midrand in South Africa, I am inviting you for another second round of a prayer meeting. We're going to pray. As you know, Wednesdays are our prayer days. We are going to be praying together. If you're not a member of our church and you want to join this prayer meeting, we have a prayer revolution going on at our church. And so please come and join with us even as we pray together. You don't have to be a member of our church to come and pray with us. You can come and join us and pray with us. And, you know, the Lord will be ministering to us in such a special way. And we also, you know, share some some word there. You know, we have some Bible study and we also pray. So come and join with us. God has a miracle for you and God has a word for you this morning. So thank you so much for joining me and have a great day. And may the Lord keep you. May the Lord guide you. May the Lord lead you by His Spirit in the name of Jesus. Go out there and win. Go out there and occupy. Go out there and make a difference. Go out there and pursue after peace in Jesus' name. God bless you. I will see you tonight at 6:30 at our church, House of Faith Church. Good day.
This church was established in 2006, you know, in a little primary school here in Midrand, Poplar Street in Noordwijk, Midrand. And God has raised us up, and for all these 16 years that we've been in existence, we have seen, you know, the hand of God. We have seen God do great things. And I tell you, the best is yet to come. You know, we believe that we're still going to see great and mighty things.
I've been at House of Faith for about 8 years now. I am serving in the Faith Kids Zone. I'm a Faith Kids Zone teacher. I love House of Faith with all my heart, and I have grown so much since I've joined the church. It's a prayerful church.
This place is so wonderful. You know, I'll tell you, when I joined here, I was coming from somewhere and I arrived here, man, I felt the welcome and all the love, the people, the ushers were wonderful that day. And up until today, I joined the team.
Just to let the people know about the vision of our church.
Yes.
That it is to proclaim the word of God.
Yes.
To all the world, to be changing, making disciples.
Yeah.
Changing lives and creating an impact worldwide.
That's
so
right.
That is the vision of this church.
We have amazing worship, amazing children's church. We have amazing youth. We call them SDY, Sons and Daughters of Yahweh. You know, we have all sorts of ministries you can think of. You know, we have great ushers that will usher you in the presence of the Lord. You know, we have men of faith. We have women of faith. You know, we have young adults. We have evangelism team. We have all sorts of teams here that, you know, are here to serve you and to minister to your life.
It is a great journey to be where we are. We are led by a very good pastor who fears the Lord, who has a vision for good and greater things.